I think it's every law student's dream to see the implementation of the law. And today at HNLU, we've seen that law goes beyond the books.
On 1st October, the Vice-Chancellor of the Hidayatullah National Law University stepped down. Why? Because the students needed justice and they weren't going to settle for anything less.
One of the biggest reasons why HNLU ki Azadi even started in the very first place was the rampant complaints of sexual harassment ongoing within this campus.
Multiple representations were made from the part of the students to implement various UGC guidelines and regulations which were not being implemented inside the university.
Even though we had so much support, we were dealing with hostile administration.
With every protest, there is a point where you reach a threshold point where the benefits of a protest will start outweighing the costs of a protest, which is what happened in our protest.
Vice-Chancellor Sukpal Singh was charged with broadly three categories of complaints: financial fraud, maladministration, and inaction on the complaints of sexual harassment. In addition, allegations of making sexist remarks himself.
76 official complaints of sexual harassment, ranging from sexist remarks, sexist undertones, commenting, and genuinely open invitations of going on coffee dates, on going on trips to Rishikesh or Chitrakoot, etc., etc., of not telling their parents, guardians about it.
The maladministration and the corruption, along with the sexual harassment cases, was such a big impediment to our university and to what we were getting from our university.
51 students who had made an official complaint before him regarding case of sexual harassment by a faculty member was not taken up by him. There was no investigation which was done by him.
Professors were hostel wardens and members of the internal complaint committee were alleged perpetrators themselves. The centralization of power in the university was to the extent that while the maximum age limit for a VC is 65 years, Mr. Singh went on to change the age limit to 70 years to continue being in charge. The High Court declared this invalid, saying it wasn't in the VC's ambit of power to do so. Before dissent erupted into protest, students tried having a dialogue, but
now you mend your behavior, and in future, if I receive any complaint regarding your behavior with the students, then I'll go ahead with this complaint and take stern action against you. के बाद में मेरे घर में कुछ व्यक्तिगत प्रॉब्लम थी, मेरे छोटे वाले साले साहब की तबीयत खराब थी, उसका ये लीवर और किडनी ट्रांसप्लांट हुआ था, मैं उसमें चला गया वहाँ मद्रास. Ultimately, he died also. उसके बाद में फिर मैं दिल्ली चला गया वहाँ पे. इसमें जो एक फॉर्मल एक्शन होना चाहिए था वो आगे इनिशिएट नहीं हो पाया.
सर, माना कि आपके पास टाइम नहीं था, बट सर, जिस टाइम में आपने उस टीचर को बुला के ऐसे क्वेश्चन किया, उसकी जगह आप ICC को भी तो डायरेक्ट कर सकते थे. बिकॉज ये सेक्शुअल हरासमेंट कंप्लेंट्स का रूल होता है कि जो स्टूडेंट ऐसे सामने आके अगर कंप्लेन कर रहा है और ही इज अ फैकल्टी मेंबर, ही कांट टीच इन दैट सेक्शन. आज भी वो फैकल्टी उसका वाइवा ले रहा है उस लड़की का, आज भी वो उन सारे बच्चों को पढ़ा रहा है जिनकी 51 सिग्नेचर्स थे.
अगर आप चीजों को रैशनलाइज नहीं करेंगे, उसका इलाज नहीं है मेरे पास. एक चीज को आप खींचे मत, एक चीज को आपको मैं बता रहा हूँ, मेरी पर्सनल प्रॉब्लम्स थी. मैं एक वाइस चांसलर भी हूँ और मैं एक इंसान भी हूँ, एक परिवार का सदस्य भी हूँ. मेरे परिवार का सदस्य इतनी बड़ी परेशानी में पड़ा हुआ है, तो मुझे वो भी देखना होता है.
ठीक है सर, हम नेक्स्ट
थोड़ा सा ट्राई टू अडॉप्ट ह्यूमैनिटेरियन अप्रोच.
After 2.5 hours of discussion in the general body meeting, a no confidence motion was run through, and all the 800 students who were present in the general body meeting signed the petition and expressed their no confidence and lack of faith on Dr. Sukpal Singh and his administration.
As the protests grew larger in audience and supporters with the help of social media first and then some national attention, the students started receiving appeals from the administration.
The Vice Chancellor, by releasing appeals, which were not appeals, I mean they were threats, and not very well disguised either. In the first appeal, he threatened us with disciplinary action if we don't call the protest off. The second one talked about imposing a sine die, which is basically closing down the university, all the common facilities. So basically he was hitting us where, you know, we were the most vulnerable.
Protests turned into a hunger strike, and at the end of the first day of the strike, the news finally arrived.
5 minutes ago, our communication was mailed from the National Office stating that Dr. Supal Singh has resigned.
What is a constitution without constitutionalism? And the students at HNLU know that firsthand. And therefore, I believe that the onus is on us to make sure that the law is implemented as we're the ones studying and preaching it.
The story of HNLU ki Azadi has become a powerful reminder of why voicing dissent and fighting injustice is paramount. Because more important than any pillar of democracy today is the voice of its people.